Hi friends, the intention of this particular video is to show you guys mainly two things. One is the input hub that is available in the LG 2014 repository solutions, which is a refined one compared to the previous input hub that they had. There were several new features that are available and it is a very simple and intuitive interface. So I will show you that. And next to that, after going through that, we will be seeing how to set up a universal control in an LG TV. So as you could see, this is the input hub, where on the left side you could see the number of inputs, whether it is HDMI or AV or component or composite, whatever it is. So you could select an input, you could rename an input. That is the very essence of this year 2014 hub, because you could rename. What happens is, before the TVs, we had that confusion, HDMI 1, which is that PlayStation, or DTH, like that, the confusion was there, right? So in order to eliminate that, LG this year given us this opportunity. So I am renaming this one to DTH. I will rename it as because the look at the input, we are playing the sources from DTH. So I am just giving it the name DTH to make it understandable. Means why you are switching the input, you will come to know that yes, this is the DTH. So you could select it simply like that. Look at on the left side of the panel, you could see that the name got changed, and Yamaha is the actually I have renamed the HDMI 1 for Yamaha, because I've connected my home theater input over there through the optical. So that's why it shows Yamaha on the second, and live TV is the primary input where I'm not using it, because I'm not having a coaxial input to be connected via a tuner or something. So next we could see how to set up a universal control. As you could see, I have selected HDMI 2 for setting up this universal control, because I have connected my DTH over there and I need to control my DTH using my magic remote. That is the aim. So I have selected HDMI 2 inside the device connector, and most probably I'm from India, so this is from the Indian context I'm telling. Most probably the DTH operator won't be listed, so you don't have to worry. Go to the not listed option, and after you selected this particular option, going inside, this particular setting up universal control will work for every DTH operator except Videocon. For Videocon also it works, but for those who are using RF remote, it won't work, because this one, this magic remote is actually using Bluetooth for communication purpose. That's a problem. Universal control cannot be used along with the RF remote. But apart from that, for Airtel, Dish TV, or any other operator, Tata Sky, it works like a gem, no problem, there is no issue. But not every single remote button can be mapped. That is the only issue. So as you could see, this list shows some of the, I thought of scrolling through this a little bit slow, because so that you could see those who are looking for whether that particular operator from your region is available or not, you could just take a look at the list. It's in the alphabetical order, so just you may take a look. If you missed the ABCD, you could go back and just check it out. Okay, just for your just to help you guys only, I just thought of slowing the video a little bit down here. So next, after I have selected Videocon, since I'm using Videocon, so there it will show the remote control types. You could select the remote control type. If the first one, the default one, is working, there is no need to switch for 2 or 3. But if it is not working, you could check it by increasing the volume or changing the channel or something like that. So if it is not working, switch to remote 2 or 3, it will work for sure. So likewise, you could set up other devices also. For example, if you're having a home theater or you're having any other device to be set up along with this, you could do that also very easily. So if you're asking me, this is a very good feature. This input hub is very, very good, because both input hub and the universal control comes inside the device connector. And this time, I think it's very simple and it's very useful for elders also, because they don't know what is HDMI 1, HDMI 2. But if you're renaming it to some Blu-ray player or DTH or something like that, TV channel, something like that, they will come to know that, yes, this is the particular input they are looking for. And similar to that, this universal control is also a very good feature, because once you set up that, you could use a single remote for controlling several devices, and the several devices, the volume up, channel down, or channel change or going for a program guide, everything can be done using a single remote. So I think these two features are very important and very promising. That's why I thought of letting you know about this. And so hope you guys enjoyed watching this time too. So do check out other videos in my channel. Stay tuned. Cheers.